A new vision now, I want to share this with you, has emerged of members of the Biden-Harris team working out ways to get evidence of Joe Biden's mental decline, evidence we showed you every week for years on this program, shut down as misinformation. Here's a bit of Biden-Harris digital director Rob Flaherty on a Zoom call explaining how the Democrat National Committee created a program to track what they believe to be disinformation and get platforms to shut it down.
One of the smartest things that I think the party did itself was over the last couple of years, they actually invested in a team that Tim runs, and you'll hear from Tim, to detect and track misinformation and misinformation narratives in the sort of various corners of the internet. And then actually go out and flag it to platforms as a violation of their policy.
Now, we gotta then wonder, what sort of things might they consider misinformation or disinformation?
It is one thing to know that there is a lot of conversation online about corruption or you know, mental fitness or any of these things, you know, the vice president's record on the crime bill, which, you know, was sort of a controversial piece of legislation in the early 90s. But it was another to go, okay, now what?
Ah, yes. Topics like Biden's mental fitness, Biden family corruption, even a stance on a crime bill. All of this, which I think should be discussed, well, to them, to the left, it's misinformation. Disinformation, and it needs to be censored. Now, on that same call, Becca Rinkovich, Joe Biden's rapid response director, also classified talk of Biden's mental decline as misinformation and disinformation around his mental acuity.
We saw a huge amount of volume and a lot of impact on narratives like Joe Biden was being manipulated by the radical left and disinformation around his mental acuity.
And Becca revealed a whole sinister plan they had to track people across the internet to counter this disinformation.
We targeted folks based on online behavioral cues, building out personas based on the type of content they were consuming, what they were searching, the kinds of websites they were visiting, so that we could target folks in real time as they were exposed to that disinformation.
Well, there you have it. The White House, people working for Joe Biden and the Democrats, talking about targeting people for spreading narratives that they found unhelpful, which they then call misinformation. Now, when you take this along with other data we've seen in so-called Twitter files about the way the White House directly heavied social media platforms, including the pre-Elon Twitter, or X as it is now, to again shut down unhelpful, but as would later turn out to be true, narratives about Biden's health and much else, including COVID besides, that doesn't sound much like the freedom that they're talking about, does it? I mean, it only about as much as we associate this famous left winger with the emotion of joy.
What a great honor to be able to introduce for the first time ever anywhere the 45th.
No! Now, we got some more breaking news here from the growing scandal of vice presidential nominee Tim Walz and claims that he lied about his military record. New vision has just surfaced of Walz telling Gold Star families at a congressional committee hearing about his experience with PTSD when he returned from military service. Have a look.
And both of you, with your keen understanding of how this works, especially from National Guard families, I can tell you this, having been one of those that came back, we were in support of OEF, but being sitting in there with OEF, OIF veterans, when we came back, they showed us the horse whisperer and told us to be nice when we went home. And that was the extent of it. That was in 2004. Now, I'm proud to say that because of the people sitting in here and people who came before me, things have changed over the last 4 years.
Gosh, you see what he does there? He's implying that said he came back from Afghanistan or Iraq, but in fact, the only thing he didn't come back from is in fact, he came back from Italy. This issue keeps getting worse and worse for the Democrats. And the fact that the Democrats had to have known about these problems with Tim Walz and still picked him, well, to me, that shows just how contemptuous they are of military service and the American voter.